Andrea P. Vybz of PlayVYBZ.com for ViewNowTV, and we are about to speak with Anthony David. His fans include First Lady Michelle Obama, who recommended his CD in an interview that she did with Marie Claire magazine, and he will be performing in the UK. So make sure you open up a tab and check him out on YouTube. So when you've done that, you'll be back here on ViewNowTV. Don't go anywhere. We've got some amazing interviews coming up.
Good, how are you doing?
Yeah, good to meet you too. So you're no stranger to London. We know that you've performed for one of the most popular and the most respected musical shows on the BBC here, the Jules Holland Show.
Yeah, it was a couple of years ago. My first album, the first album released here was called Red Clay Chronicles. It was my second album, but first one released here. And yeah, Jules was nice enough to have me on.
I wanted to ask you, from your perspective as an artist, what the crowds are like as compared to, say, an Atlanta crowd or maybe any other international crowd here in London. Do you find there's a difference?
Not so much, really. Well, you know, a lot of cultures now, we see each other. We do a lot of the same things. Soul music's not new to the UK, Europe, for that matter. Maybe a difference in song, set, you know what I mean? But other than that, no, not really.
Good, so you get an equal spread of love everywhere across the globe.
I like to think so, yeah.
Brilliant. Now, we've been playing lots of your tracks, present and past. So right about now, you are promoting your album Location, Location, Location.
And then, a few new acoustic songs in this thing called Location, 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 because I feel like I'm in a good space. Don't y'all feel like I'm in a good space right now? So we're working on a new album. It's called Love Out Loud, and it will be coming out through Dome Records. It's their 20th anniversary, as a matter of fact. They are the people who put me out in the UK, so big them up all the time, right? And records are here over here for sale if you don't have any of them things, all right? So we're going to get right into it. I hear this one is doing all right over here. Gentlemen, let's make this roll call real quick. Where y'all at? Yeah, that's pretty weak. How about this? Ladies, where y'all at? So gentlemen, do you want to speak up now? Well, look at it, don't worry about it. I'm gonna help you out. Let's do this one. See, I'm a team player, fellas. So I'm gonna help you out. You gotta be able to read the body language, you understand what I'm saying? Ladies, for sure. Let me tell you about it. Here we go.
Haven't you been watching the way that she moves? She's been doing everything in her power to get your eye.
Hey, I hear y'all.
Look, have you even noticed it's all about you? But if you miss it, she gon' end up keep looking to another guy. Hey, what? She's waiting on you. Say it's alright. It's all up to you. Make it alright. If there was any other brother, he knows. Get in her groove. Don't Don't be afraid, pull her up to your clothes, look her in her eyes. Don't worry about the next time.
For those of the listeners and viewers who are not so familiar with what you've done in the past, what can they expect from Location, Location, Location?
Well, that one's kind of a merge of, like, so my first album that I recorded, not the one that came out here on Dome Records first, Three Chords and the Truth was an acoustic affair, and I did Red Clay Chronicles and As Above, So Below recently came out. Location, Location, Location is a remix, some remixes from As Above, So Below, and a little bit of acoustic stuff that would be reminiscent of the first album, which is Three Chords and the Truth.
Okay, brilliant stuff. So tonight, you're all set for your performance?
Oh yeah, all ready to go, yeah. A Jazz Cafe is a great place. They welcome me here, or did their album release here, and so back here to do it again.
Again, who are coming and discovering your music for the first time, they might be aware, having done their research on you, that you are not only a Grammy nominated artist in your own right, but of course your contribution to India Ari's work, which also won a Grammy, is very much in the neo soul vein. Is there any other influences that people can expect to hear from your set?
Oh, a billion. We do a couple of 80s tunes, you know. I've always covered one on my, on the albums, Tears for Fears, Level 42, Something About You. They actually shot the video here. Some hip-hop, all kinds of things like that.
So in terms of UK artists, is there anybody that you just die in to collaborate with, either on the hip-hop scene or on the R&B or soul scene, or reggae for that matter, or any other genre?
Yeah, well, I'm a big fan of a lot of UK artists, particularly Omar. One of the tunes on this album is heavily influenced by him. I actually wanted him to produce that one too, it would've been neat. But people like him in the States, we have Estelle's doing really well, me and her are friends, that'd be nice. People like that.
Mm. Okay, so you're feeling the Estelle vibe?
Yeah, she's dope.
Brilliant.
Oh yeah, I finally met Roses Gabor. Like, she's done this thing with this guy Subtract. She's always had tunes that I liked, and we finally met face to face because we've always like complimented each other online and whatnot. I'm a big fan of hers, yeah.
Oh, excellent. So what do you think of the whole kind of UK versus US? Are you buying into sometimes the fact that people feel they have to go to America and break the scene, or, you know, what do you feel about the independent UK music scene?
Oh, it's great. I mean, I think just in terms of numbers or whatever, America is like the biggest market for selling records, so I guess you want to do that, but I mean, but obviously, artists that do really well over here, if you do it right, you can have a good living. Kelly Rowland did well. You know, Robbie Williams from here, for some reason, never really broke in the States, but that didn't hurt his career at all. So.
That's right. So I have to ask you, how did it feel when you heard that the First Lady, Mrs. Michelle Obama, name-checked you in an interview that she did and spoke about your music and her being a fan? How did that feel when you got that news?
It was good. I mean, I'm, I guess you could say, a fan of theirs, you know what I mean? That sounds weird talking about a president like that, but, you know, I'm a supporter, and I like what they stand for, so that's like the epitome of somebody I would want to be listening to my music.
Sure. Well, hopefully if they're watching, perhaps an invitation to perform the next White House event will be on its way to you.
Yeah, I haven't been to the White House yet. We've been doing some campaign stuff with them in different cities, but I haven't been to the White House yet. I look forward to it.
Okay. So 2012, we're kind of halfway through. What can people expect from you for the rest of this year?
Oh, we got a new single we're shooting a video for as soon as we get back, called So Jaded. New album called Love Out Loud. Should be out by fall. And that's it. Just keep moving.
Okay, excellent. Well, I want to thank you so much for your time today, Anthony. And really look forward to the show.
I appreciate you. Yeah, come out tonight.
Thank you, definitely. Well, once again, this is your girl, Andrea P. Vybz, for ViewNow TV, and we have just had the pleasure of sitting here and speaking with Mr. Anthony David, one of the staples of the neo-soul scene. If you haven't already checked out his stuff, make sure you Google him immediately. So on behalf of PlayVYBZ.com, your platform for authentic creative expression, Brixton's very own radio station for ViewNow TV.
Oh.